I say top 10 in the league for sure.
Of course. My in the league, he's top 10.
Top 10 for sure in the league.
But I don't think he's a great player.
Just my thought is if you're top 10 on my list, you're a great player. So, but understandable. You could have good and great in your top 10. It's yours.
He's good.
Okay.
He's good. One thing that I knock on his game, offensively, he's a fucking weapon.
He is.
Defensively,
he's a nothing.
He ain't shit. So that's
one
why
side
I can't,
of the ball.
That's yeah. why I can't say he's great. Kawhi Leonard is developing to a great player.
Iverson was a great player. You think he was a great defender?
Iverson was a great on the ball defender. Notice I said on the ball.
I thought he was a good off the ball defender because he always had Eric Snow to help his ass.
Hey.
But
he
love
played,
Iverson.
He played
Iverson
the passing lane well too, but face to face, Iverson played good defense. Mm-hmm. No bullshit. Iverson had a long ass wingspan with some long ass hands, man. His back scratches was long, man.
He did. That's how he could jump out the gym and he could go for a layup and then dunk it. You'd be like, how the hell he even like he was up that high to dunk?
Yeah. You know, so I mean, James Harden, Rockets, they're gone.
They're gone.
They're out. So we got the
Spurs, Warriors.
Spurs and Warriors.
Who you got? And how many games?
If I can get a healthy Kawhi and this unit play like they played against the Rockets.
The last two games, for
these
sure.
These last two games.
Yeah.
I'm taking the Spurs.
Really?
Yeah. But that unit, that bench for the Spurs and role players, how they came together and they spread that ball around and you know, they shared the ball. That's what Golden State does. Golden State shares the ball a lot, but Golden State takes a lot of bad shots.
They do. It's just some nights they make you pay, some nights they don't.
You get what I'm saying?
Based on that shot selection. Absolutely.
They have to disrupt Curry's whole rhythm before he gets into a shot.
I just feel like the Warriors have the Spurs number. I'm sorry.
No.
They got their number. It'll be over in 6 or 5, in my opinion. I think it'll be over 6 or 5. I think Warriors will win.
I got Spurs in 7.
I think Kawhi's really hurt. I think he's really hurt. I think even if he comes back and plays.
That's why I say. Pending Kawhi's health.
I just think even if he comes back and plays, I don't even want your what you stated to be valid and the listeners to take it valid because he's not going to be the same player. Because he'll come back and play.
Never
but
know.
I think he's really hurting bad. I don't think he's going to be the same player.
Never know,
but
man.
But we'll see.
Never know.
We'll see.
You know, they already playing good as a unit. You know, let's not discredit Pop, and he has a system.
A great system.
You know, so Kawhi, hey. When it comes to game time, Pop gonna forget about Kawhi.
Yeah.
And he's gonna game plan with the players he got, and they gonna go out there and they gonna compete and they gonna play.
They gonna have the coaching. They always had a coaching.
So let's not discredit, you know, the architect behind the whole motherfucking system.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Kawhi's just a piece. You think he don't prepare for shit like this? Come on, Tony Parker went down. Look what happened. Patty Mills stepped up. And Patty Mills has been playing good.
And we didn't think he was gonna do that.
Damn near great.
He has. Yeah, I didn't think he was going to play that well. He's been playing his ass off.
Let's not discredit these players, man.
Yeah.
Golden State, yeah, they the high flying, and you know they out there in the advertisement and then people eyeing everything else. Yeah, that's all they see. But come on, man.
I just feel like that Golden State machine is too good, man. It's well oiled.
They're human.
They are human.
They have bad nights. They have shown it. They have shown where they can be stagnant at times.
Yeah, but they don't have multiple bad nights.
They don't have multiple bad nights.
That's the problem. You gotta hope they have four bad ones.
But when you go against them Spurs, you can't make mistakes.
No.
Because they capitalize on, and that's what James Harden did. He had, what, damn the 10 turnovers yesterday? They capitalize off the Houston's mistakes.
But I really believe that Houston, as well as the Thunder, they're not really great teams. They're good teams. They're in their positions in the West, but the caliber of just like
Houston has a good team. Bullshit. You got Eric Gordon. You got Capella that was playing at a high fucking level. He was a defensive stopper down there. One shit coming down in that hole, man. I said Eric Gordon, Capella. You had Lou Williams. Mm-hmm. You got Harden. And you got fucking the boy from Chicago.
Oh, Beverly.
Beverly.
Yeah,
come on now, man. We discrediting.
I'm sorry. This squad had a great year. It was a great system implemented by D'Antoni.
It was no defense.
Well, that's the Capella
and Beverly can only do so much.
Yeah, that's the D'Antoni
system. Don't forget Trevor Ariza.
Trevor's always consistent.
Who played with Kobe?
Trevor's always consistent. But this squad, come on, man. You got to say the way they went out.
And Ryan Anderson, a three-point specialist. This team was well put together.
But this Spurs squad was way better than this team. And they had some good games.
Compared to what the Spurs put out there last night, Houston was the better team. Spurs had the better game plan, and they strategized better, and they executed it.
So it all goes together.
What goes together?
Everything you just said, which is why they're still the superior team. Better coaching, better game plan.
But you're not giving them a chance against Golden State.
Because
with all those factors in place, everything, all those components in place.
Right, right.
You're not giving them a chance against Golden State.
Because Golden State is the standard.
And when
in the
they
West,
showed
man.
You a team that's put together nice with scores,
but that's what
and they shut them down, but then they beat them by 40.
But that's the point I'm trying to make. That Golden State squad is not a pushover like that Thunder squad and like that Houston squad.
But that's the thing. Like I said, they're human beings. They can. You got to figure. They got to come back and stick these same caliber players. These caliber players are talented and skillful. And they can score. Don't forget you got Danny Green. Coaching is what's going to come down to. And Steve Curry ain't on the side. You got Mike Brown.
I'm telling you. The Warriors in 5 or 6, man. We're going to leave it at that. 5 or 6. I'm sorry, man. I hope the Spurs can do something, but I don't foresee that happening. I just don't see it happening.
I got the Spurs in 7.
So we'll so you got 7. So let's go ahead. We'll go bet on the air now.
Is that what you want to do?
We're going to bet a case of brews.
My choice?
Your choice. Case of brews, well, any choice, whoever wins. So, case of brews. I say 5 or 6. So, if it goes 7, I automatically lose the bet, even if we don't know who wins the series. If it goes 7, I lose. So, I say it's over in 5 or 6 and the Warriors win. You say it goes 7, the Spurs win. Leave it at that.
So, case of brew?
Case of brew.
Y'all heard it right here. I'm bringing it. Heard it on the sports talk.
You heard
it. That's Jah P. He made a bet with me, and I made it official. I take it. I got the Spurs in 7. Gonna get into a little more music. Then we're gonna come back. We're gonna talk a little bit more, and then we're gonna wrap it up. Victor Cruz, he stopped by in Chicago.
Who cares?
Oh, come on, man. This dude here, I like it.
Who cares if Victor Cruz? Victor Cruz's knees are still in New York, even though he stopped by in Chicago.
The Trubisky. Am I saying his name now?
Trubisky. It's getting better. It's getting better. It's better than it was the last
I am
second.
Getting better at his
you
name.
You are getting better.
Trubisky, yeah. He showed up, you know, in his grandma's car.
97 Toyota.
We're going to talk a little bit about that. And like I said, we're going to come back, talk a little bit more, wrap it up. And, man, hope y'all enjoy the podcast right here on Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. I'm your host, the Blaq Hippie, with my homie down here in the Player K. What's your name, B?
Jah P.
And what's your name, else?
Jah P. What down, world?
Man, I got some Jeezy. What y'all talking about?
Black of the berry, the sweet of the juice. I say the Black of the rim, the sweet of the cup. That money goes out, that set comes in. I can't even lie, I do it all again. I flipped the rap game, just like the work. And it was Snow White, just like a shirt. Got so much paper, seen so many haters. Seen bricks stacked on the skyscrapers. Goddamn, that's high. You done everything I said, so I am that fly. Every word was the truth. Tell me who came villa. The word on the street is that I'm still that nigga. Living my life, and I'ma get it all, no matter the price. When I did it, you know I done it the best. Sit back and just hold your breath, and just hold your breath. Changing the game, and showing you how these rapping ass niggas is lame. When I did it, you know I done it the best. Sit back and just hold your breath, just hold your breath. Between love and hate, there's a thin ass line. I think we all can agree, last summer was mine. And if you don't say my name, then you're wasting your time. And if I don't wear my watch, then I'm wasting my shine. Spent $100 on it, homie, and didn't set the time. A few mil before the deal, and I'm still on the grind. The critics criticizing cause a nigga talking, yeah. I ain't sugarcoating shit, this is who I am. Nigga, you been to the A, you see me making it rain. Seen it with your own eyes, you know this shit ain't a game. So you niggas listen closely to what I'm saying. Saying the game ain't money, then I ain't playing. Let's get it. Living my life, and I'ma get it all, no matter the price. When I did it, you know I done it the best. Sit back and just hold your breath, just hold your breath. Changing the game, and showing you how these rapping ass niggas is lame. When I did it, you know I done it the best. Sit back and just hold your breath, just hold your breath.
Bring your A-game Sports Talk Radio. We back in your ear down here in the Player Cave, delivering y'all another podcast talking Chicago sports and more.
Off the cuff, real quick.
Here you go with this off
the cuff. This is a quick one.
I guess we're going to have an off the cuff segment with your ass.
Nah. This is the last one.
This is the start, man.
It's the last one. This is the first one you can answer quickly.
What up, though?
Better dunker, Vince Carter, Dominique Wilkins.
Oh, shit. Hey, you been coming with some tough ones.
Who's the better dunker? Just black and white. You say the name. Don't talk about the style of dunk or none of that shit.
So don't elaborate.
Don't elaborate. Who's in your opinion.
Just pick A or B.
In your opinion, you pick A or B and then say why after you pick them.
Vince.
Or Dominique.
Vince.
Okay. Why?
The reason why I wrote with VC, don't get me wrong. Dominique.
It's okay. You don't have to explain.
Okay.
Because we know what Dominique was, but just say why Vince for you.
Grace.
Okay.
A little bit of extra style. And it was like poetry in the air. How gracefully he moved in the air.
Yeah. Vince had it. But I say Dominique. Because for me,
Dominique gave me style and power.
Power.
Vince gave me power.
Power.
Grace.
I've never seen another player that could windmill two-handed and finish that strong on five people.
I ain't never seen a player jump over a seven-footer and completed it clean. And I don't mean just throw it down like Blake Griffin did that one time. I mean,
yeah, that's not dunking.
I mean, jump over, you completed it clean.
Clean, yeah.
Dunk.
Clean dunk. Yeah.
Gotta go with Vince.
I'm just power. Power in that windmill.
Vince give you power.
Put you in a trance.
Vince give you power too. But
all right, let's get.
I like the off the cut. I like that one though. That was a good one. I got one for your ass too.
Oh, you? I know you got one. You got one, bro.
Let me get back on my shit, man. What's today's date? 12th.
Yeah, today's 12th.
Get back on my Bulls facts and shit. Now we coming up to the pod. We wrapping up the show. Fact. In 1979-80, the first season with a three-point shot, the Bulls made 70 trays in 275 attempts. True or false?
False.
Fact or fiction?
I say false.
That's a fact.
Really? I don't know shit about the 79-80 Bulls, so you got me on that one, bro.
How would you give
I wasn't born until 84.
Like that, man. You got me. Goddamn questions like you got me.
You
man,
got
what
me.
The hell wrong you with got it, me. Man. But yeah, man. Who you got tonight? Wizards or Celtics?
I think the Celtics gonna close it out.
Too much on. You think Celtics gonna?
Yeah, I think Celtics gonna close.
I'm gonna take the Wizards. I don't think they're gonna go down like that.
Yeah, I don't really want to see either one of them play the Cleveland. I wish Cleveland could just go to the final.